talking section, the closer they get to me, the better. Or I'm gonna have to start climbing up the stairs and bring you the microphone. I'd be happy to do that. Let me see, what did I miss that I wanna celebrate today? I wanna congratulate Mr. Michael Lau and our speech and debate team. I'm so glad you're clapping before you know what they did. Good. The following students' place in the speech and debate team. Storytelling, second place was Hillman Tollefson. Third place was Samuel Yeager. Fourth place, Isaiah Lau. Fifth place was Miranda Martinez. Humorous interpretation, third place, Isaiah Lau. Fourth place was Gio DeMartini. And for duo interpretation, fourth place, Gio DeMartini and Mia Cepeda, I believe. Yes, and it's funny, I just got a text from someone who is so clever. She was actually ahead of what I was just about to say, because how can we not bring up Kahuku's own Ian Bogey? I've sent out those instructions so many times. I know that we're all very proud of Ian, and he might even be watching. He can't be here with us on island, but he is very proud to be a Kahuku Red Raider and has totally represented Kahuku to the world with the millions of views he's had. Yeah, so congratulations, Ian Tongi Ma'opaku from the Red Raider Nation.
Engraved in every Tongan heart is the national motto, Koe o tua mo Tonga, ko hoku tofia. God and Tonga are my heritage. In other words, for tonight's performance, we wish to express our love and gratitude to our Father in Heaven and to you, our Tonga. We would have never been able to witness the miracles of Kahuku High School without God and Tonga in our lives. We are truly living a heritage of miracles.
We have witnessed so many miracles, such as in sports with football and volleyball. We've also learned many miraculous life lessons inside and outside of the classroom. But most importantly, the miracle we will always treasure was having you as family and friends throughout our academic journey. So families and friends, sit back, relax, and enjoy this segment as we say Malo'a Pito for the legacy that we have come to love and appreciate. Please welcome Tonga.
Oh, Thank you.
Was written by Menetamwe Bell's grandfather, the late Afuha'amango. And Mafifakapotu is a title that was also invested in the personage of the president of the Polynesian Cultural Center, which means that the current president also has the title of Mafifakapotu, as given by Tafa'ahau Tutou IV, something that historically happened never outside of the Kingdom of Tonga, but here in La'i. And watch those kids run all the way up the stairs because they got to get ready for the next section. And before we take you to Fiji, I'd just like to say that I am sitting in the stands. This is how it feels to be in the VIP section. I've never been in the VIP section. I'm always in the servant position. And the VIP section feels bougie and awesome. To my left is the Vice President of Cultural Presentations from the Polynesian Cultural Center, Auntie Delsa Moy! Come on, stand up, Delsa. This is a red grader mother right here. Next to Paki Paki, Huluna! Yes! And on my right is Donna Lindsay, Dr. Donna Lindsay, our wonderful principal. Yes. Give it up for the principal. You can turn the lights off. I like the dark. I think I look better in the dark. Yes, and so it's cooler. Now we're gonna actually feature the Fijian performance, but I just wanted to know what it feels like to sit in the VIP section. And now I'm feeling like we need to have a Pacific Theateroke. Pacific Theateroke, maybe just like a 1.5 minute song, because when you're a grandma or a tutu like I am, you cannot sing a whole song without running out of breath. So, Fehi, whatever you got over there, play whatever you got. Oh my goodness, not the oldies, we really gonna fall asleep now. Can't you let go of the 90s at least? His smile is not the first heartbroken. My eyes are not the first to cry. Sing along. Not the first, no. There's just no getting over you.
Oh,
Missy Boyle will have everybody the next American Idol.
Tonight, dancing with us, we have 9 Fijian descendants who will be performing for the first time. And so we'd like to invite them to make their way to the stage, along with their loved ones who will be helping with the ceremony. They're coming from Fiji. So once they make their way, once again, we have the opportunity to do this, and although we're not, or we haven't been raised in Fiji, we have the opportunity to perpetuate culture in this way. Now, among our Fijian students and our Fijian dancers, I'll announce them as they make their way down. We have Asia Alanieta Andy Sobanatapua Evans, who is the daughter of Roy and Kelera Tui Nakawanja Evans. We have Mia Vernice Taealuanua Posse, who is the daughter of Raymond and Jackie Peters Posse. We have Stefania Maramasina Peters, daughter of Vern and Josephine Peters. Jared Emery Ho'omaluhia Apa, son of Robert and Peniet Sokia Apak. We have Stanley Simamao Fanoimoana Ross, son of John and Kailani Ross. We also have Leah Hinawariki Mo'o Suimika, daughter of Amani and Ruita Suimika. Andy Paulini Samanulu Malawani Mataka Vesikula Ratusaki, daughter of William and Mary Ratusaki. Tekihi Liliele Taliu, daughter of Kenneth and Sela Taliu. And Devita Seru Tuimoala Ikakoma, son of Andiala and Andisiki Sumuturanga Ikakoma. Now, as they make their way to the state. It's customary that they wear tapa, but also provided for them, and we use now is material, and so the yards that they have been provided by their loved ones. Now, as mentioned earlier, it is customary in the Fijian culture that when a youth performs for the first time, there's a ceremony done, which is this, and the outer material, or tapa, is removed. The role of removing the tapa or material is given to special women who have played a significant role in the individual's life. This evening, some of those important women, and we'll invite them to begin to remove the outer clothing. Now is Margaret Sokia, Kenesi Tulebe, Phyllis Peters and Mariah Ayu, Jacqueline Ayava, Maya Babu, Yvette Fonemoana, Tati Pane'e, Stella Taliu, Tamara Soliai, and we also have Keleni Barabilama. And if Kalera Tuinakawandra is here, she may also make her way down.
Actually, I'm dressing Asia Alanieta Andisova Natambua Evans Obi Kanani Lewenlovo, who is an auntie to Asia. Father is Ratu Jochi Lewenlovo, younger brother to Asia's grandmother, Auntie Kuini Tuisabura.
Now this is a representation of the transition from childhood into that of young adults. The shedding or the removing of the tapa or material shows the removing or putting away of childish themes as they prepare to receive new responsibilities that come with young adulthood. Now it's a blessing that although not raised in the Isles of Fiji, our youth have the opportunity to learn and perpetuate the culture of their ancestors. Fiji is represented well here at Kahuku High Intermediate. Now, as they leave, how about a hand for our Fijian students and those who have worked so hard for the Fijian section?